U.S. stocks, well in the red this Friday afternoon right behind me here at the New York Stock Exchange following a mixed to lower jobs report as the U.S. economy added 151,000 jobs in January, below what economists were expecting, which was a gain of 190,000. At the same time, the unemployment rate did fall to 4.9% from 5%, while wages, they rose 0.5%. Now, the wage rate has since served as a platform for investors to believe that the Fed now has some data that may warrant a future Fed rate hike, therefore sending equities into the red as the week begins to shut down. Now, in the Forex market, the U.S. dollar remaining bearish against its counterparts, the euro dollar, about 0.5% higher, 111.44. Moving on, the British pound U.S. dollar pair about 0.75% lower, 144.79, and we have the U.S. dollar Japanese yen pair 0.94% lower, 116.93 yen. Still in focus this afternoon, the Euro-British pound pair, that is, which is on the upside and stands above the support at 0.7660. The 0.7660 level is a former resistance that has been holding the pair under pressure since late January. The upside breakout is strong and leading towards a bullish signal. Long positions above the support at 0.7660 are favored, with targets at 0.7735 and 0.7755 in extension. Precious metals again holding steady ahead of the Lunar New Year holiday in Asia. Gold is where we first begin, and it is in focus as gold is consolidating above its key support at 1147.50. The rising 50-period moving average for gold should continue to push prices higher, so long positions above the support at 1147.50 are favored, with targets at 1160 and 1166 in extension. And lastly, silver 0.44% lower, 1478 a troy ounce, and don't forget to follow Trading Central on Twitter at Trading Central for all of your Forex market updates. And for Trading Central Web TV on a Friday afternoon here at the New York Stock Exchange, wishing you a great weekend, I'm James Swinney.